Alright, Gia here with you. What's going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel. We're here in a plaza. They got a bar, a meat and produce market, a Vietnamese cuisine place, and a paint place. And then right here you have, if I can get to it because I can't see because it's bright out here, State of Florida Department of Corrections. So we're going to go up in here and A, see if they respect our right to record, and B, make a public records request. See if we have any violations. How you doing? I wanted to make a public records request, if I may, over here. How you doing? I wanted to find out how many, just for this office, how many people completed probation successfully, how many were violated, and... All right, thank you very much, Regina. All right, thank you. Prophylactics here too. Shorten your community control sentence or even convert courthouse to community service hours. Modifications of supervision may also allow you to travel out of the state or country. Another incentive may be an early termination of supervision. The minimum requirements include that all formal conditions have been completed and that all monetary obligations have been fulfilled. Even get directions on how to use one. Yeah, so. No, you're good. How you doing? All right, thank you very much. Please discuss with your probation officer the process for requesting a modification or early termination of your supervision.
How can you streamline your office visit? You will need to report as instructed. You should avoid bringing children into the office for their safety. This will also allow you and your probation officer to remain focused on your monthly visit. Schedule sufficient time in your work and personal schedule to allow you and your probation officer to review your monthly supervision report, discuss the progress of your conditions, and answer any questions you may have. Do not come into the probation office during your scheduled office visit with the expectation that your probation officer will see you immediately upon assignment. Even though the probation officer has other probationers scheduled, your officer will do their best to respect your time and see you as close to your scheduled appointment as possible. We recommend that you complete your monthly supervision report prior to arriving each month. You can request to take a blank monthly supervision report with you when you leave, or go online to the website listed on the screen and print the monthly supervision report yourself. Be sure to bring all necessary documents for your appointment, such as all current paycheck stubs, employment search logs, support group meeting logs, community service logs, or any other completion certificates that you have received since your last office visit. Finally, drink enough fluids to ensure that you are prepared for a possible drug test. There may be a time while you're on supervision that an emergency situation presents itself. In the event of emergency during non-office hours, your officer will provide a telephone number to you, which is available when the probation office is closed. Before calling the emergency telephone number, you should consider if the situation is a true emergency or if it can wait until the following business day. Some examples of a true emergency would be reporting a new arrest, a medical emergency, or a family medical emergency that may require you to leave a county or deviate from your community.
case an emergency arises. If you do use the emergency telephone number, be prepared to submit verification and documentation of the emergency to your officer the following business day. Should you encounter a life-threatening situation, always contact your local police, fire, medical, or emergency personnel prior to contacting your probation officer. If you have a complaint, also known as a grievance, or have experienced a concerning action that has occurred during your supervision period, aside from a violation, there are certain steps you will need to follow to ensure your grievance will be properly handled. You should first attempt to resolve the issue by discussing it with your probation officer in a calm and respectful manner. Oftentimes, simply by communicating with your officer, you can resolve your grievance and prevent conflicts from escalating. If you have not been able to resolve a problem by speaking directly to your officer, you may ask to speak to your officer's supervisor. If you are not satisfied with the outcome of your discussion with the supervisor, you may submit a written complaint to the supervisor within 10 days.
Hello. How you doing?
I just wanted some statistical stuff for this office. In general, I wanted to know how many people have completed probation successfully.
The supervisor will then review the written complaint.
Oh, let's do 2019.
Yeah,
and how many violated? And then I'd like to know for the month of December, how many drug screens were given, broken down by each. And I got an email. It's a GOVACC.
Don't let pride
at
way of asking for help.
Bolt Action.
BOLTACTIOA.com. Probation officers have access to information and contacts that can assist you with employment, education,
POBACC, at BOLTACTION, NWSgroup.com.
Officers can help you.
So give us some type of information.
Yeah, I know that takes time.
Yeah, we're going to go ahead and get it to you.
All right, appreciate it.
Thank you.
Hey, thank you guys for respecting the First Amendment.
Yes.
And being cordial. It's probably one of the better places I've been into.
Yes,
so,
sir. No
thanks.
Problem.
Y'all have a great day.
All right, thank you.
Well, no violations here. Probably have to go with the 360 video because I kind of set it down and walked over to her rather than picking up the camera. So, but we're still working on this, you know. Narrating, cameraman, standing up from my right, so on and so forth. Alright guys, that's probation parole in Winter Haven. I'll see you on the next one.